This is the Adreno Mega 2560. And this is the RAMPS 1.4. This is what you're going to use for a 3D printer. To connect it, you're going to connect to the female ports with the male ports on the bottom of the RAMPS. To do that, it's kind of simple. You're going to line up your pins, use a little bit of thumb pressure to make sure it is mounted correctly. When you want to load software on your Adreno, you're going to use this end of the USB cable and connect it right here. Then you're going to use the other end on your computer on your USB port. Let me describe a couple of things on the board for you here. We have our two extruders. We have E1 and E0. This is the port for the motor for E1. Here's the E0s. Then we have our end stops from here to here. This is X min. This is Y min. Or excuse me. This is X max. This is Y min. This is Y max. This is Z min, and this is Z max. Then you have your thermistor pins here. There's three sets. The first set being these is it's thermistor 0, thermistor 1, thermistor 2. Normally you would use thermistor 0 for your extruder to monitor the temperature. The second set is usually used for your print bed, and the third set is extra that you can use for other things sometimes. Then you have your stepper for your Z-axis. There are two ports for your motors. Then you have your Y, which has one port for your motor, and then you have your X, which has one port for your motor. Over here, you have two pins that you use for your fan. This side being positive, this side being negative. You have your PSU port. This is used for an on-off switch, I believe. And there are three pins here. Then you have your power reset pin. And then you have your servo pins. This is an auxiliary set of pins. This is auxiliary one. This is auxiliary two. This is auxiliary 3, and this is auxiliary 4. Over here, we have our power pins that we use for our extruder, which would be D10. This is the negative side, this is the positive side. Then you can use the next set of pins for either fans, or you can use them for your heat bed. That we'll go into a little bit later. This is the actual power supply that connects to your port to power everything. This power supply, I'm going to show you with examples using a 12 volt power supply. It can do 24, but that's more advanced. We also have some pins that I wanted to show you. These are your I2C pins. And you also have spy pins on auxiliary 3. Okay. We have the Adreno over here with the ramps on it. We have the connector that we're going to connect to the computer. Now you should hear a beep when it connects. If you don't, it might mean that your driver software is not loaded. This is a Windows-based machine. So you get a blinking light saying that it's actually connected.
Okay, for the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to go to our Marlin folder. Inside the Marlin folder, the quickest way to get to your Marlin file to start is hit the letter M. Then you want to click on the marlin.info. Okay, as soon as it opens, what we're going to do is figure out a couple of simple things. First being our USB connection. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go over to Tools, go to Ports. It appears to be on COM3, so we've checked that off. Now we need to pick the correct device. In this case, I already have it chosen. But if you need to choose it, you can choose it through here, and then the subtype, which is the 2560. Now, seeing how we're not doing much with this particular configuration, all I'm trying to show you how to do is load it. To load the firmware, you're going to hit the upload button, and what will occur is it's going to compile first to make sure there's no errors, and then it's going to upload to the device. So watch the taskbar in the middle of the screen. And right now what it's doing is it's compiling the solution file. And now it's uploading it to the Adreno 2560. If you like my video, please hit the like button and subscribe if you enjoyed these. I'll try and do at least one a week, and thank you for your time.